Uthman ordered that all other Quranic materials be burnt. So there's already been a burn the Quran day.
Miracle of reinterpretation. What does Muhammad mean when he says, if anyone leaves his Islamic religion, kill him? He clearly means that if anyone wants to leave Islam, he's free to go.
Welcome to Fun Islamic Facts. Do you like the adorable gecko from the Geico commercials? If so, you're going to hell, because Muhammad hated lizards and ordered his followers to kill them. The Messenger of Allah enjoined killing geckos, and he called them noxious little creatures. Muhammad even said that Muslims will be rewarded in paradise for killing geckos, with bonuses for efficiency.
When you're the beginning student of knowledge, you're like, what is all of this going on here?
What is this mess? Now, the reaction should be, wait a minute, I've been told all my life that the Quran has been perfectly preserved right down to the letter, and now I find out that it was all a lie. I guess I can't trust the scholars and apologists who lied to me for all these years. What does Allah mean when he says that Muslim men can beat their wives into submission? He clearly means that Muslim men are only allowed to tap their wives gently with a toothbrush.
Fun Islamic facts. The Prophet said, when you eat, do not wipe your hands till you have licked it, or had it licked by somebody else.
Sorry, they're already gone.
No, they're not. You left the best part.
No, I'm pretty sure they're...
But what happens if he digs a bit deeper, Sheikh Yasser Qadhi?
When you do a deep dive is when things get very, very awkward and difficult.
Why? Because he realizes that the responses he memorized from his scholars and apologists don't really work. From an Islamic perspective, what's the best way to avoid the confusion and awkwardness that arise for the student of knowledge? Keep people in a state of ignorance.
And I don't think it is wise to bring it up in public, because it should not be said in public. I don't want to get into that issue. I don't even want to be explicit. It should never be brought up in public. This is not something you discuss amongst the masses, Yahi. It's not wise.
This is also why there are blasphemy laws in Muslim countries. What does Allah mean in Surah 3, verses 3 to 4, when he says that he revealed the gospel as a guidance for mankind? Well, Allah means that even though he revealed the gospel, it was corrupted by the Apostle Paul and by Christians at the Council of Nicaea, and it ended up not guiding mankind. It was only a matter of time before a genius like me came up with the idea of Quran skin shoes. Shoes are always falling apart, but Allah promises to perfectly preserve his words. So, if you want a pair of shoes that will last forever, just make your shoes out of the Quran. Zakir Naik's ministry pays people to convert to Islam. Controversial Islamic preacher Zakir Naik and his non-profit Islamic Research Foundation have illegally converted around 800 people to Islam by paying them using funds received from abroad. For you Muslims who are thinking to yourself, no, Zakir Naik would never do such a thing, you should probably study the Quran and the life of your prophet, because Muhammad himself paid people to convert to Islam. And one of the reasons you pay zakat is to pay people to convert to Islam.
Oh, we know what the claim is, don't we, Kat? There is no incentive known to human beings that will convince a cat to walk or step on the Quran.
You'll all over the Quran. Just for a piece of string.
The Prophet of Islam climbed on top of his child bride when she was 9 years old. He even asked his followers why they would marry an adult woman when they could fondle little girls. We can only conclude that Muhammad would kiss and tell, because his followers knew all about him having sex with all of his wives on the same day. Muhammad's reputation spread until people didn't even want him marrying their daughters, because they thought of him as a womanizer. History of At-Tabari, volume 9, page 139. She went back to her people and said that the Messenger of God had married her. They said, "What a bad thing you have done. You are a self-respecting woman, but the Prophet is a womanizer." Some prophet you've got there, my Muslim friends.
There's nothing there.
You're just pawing at it. She's seeking knowledge. She's seeking the knowledge of Allah. She wants all the knowledge of the Quran. She's devouring the Holy Quran.
Surprise, jihadis. To the man who stole Hatun's Quran and to the morons who cheered as she was being arrested, don't ever forget that your actions led not only to more Quran desecration and more mockery of your fake prophet, but also to Hatun getting the biggest Christian apologetics channel on the planet. Instead of deleting my channel, I'm going to transfer ownership to Hatun, giving her access to all of my subscribers. All you had to do was wait. My channel was gone. I don't turn back from decisions like that. But a week before I delete my channel, you steal a Quran that I gave her, leading me to ask the question, what can I do to turn that robbery into an even bigger embarrassment for Islam? And I see British police acting like tyrants? Great job, guys. I guess Allah really is the best of planners, sending you tactical geniuses to help Hatun refute your fake prophet.
This is a power of religion, there's a reason to it. Yeah? It just backfired on you. It just backfired on you. This is a power of religion, there's a reason to it. Yeah?